Thank you, Albus. Hi, guy. It's April, and I have a dog here who decided that he's just gonna sit under the desk and cause havoc. So, if you hear any weird noises, that's him. But I am excited to get back into Beauty and Beast Winter Enchantment. The goal today is to do this bottom right corner. So, Mrs. Potts, Chips, and then this banister area. I do have a bunch of colors pulled. This I did in another video that I have linked down below in case you want to check it out and you want to see how I chose these colors. I will for sure tell you what these colors are as I'm pulling them out to use them. So, don't worry about that. Otherwise, I'm just gonna kind of jump into it, I guess. I did pull out my erasers because there's some editing I want to do with some of these purples and things that are already on here. I feel like they didn't go quite where I wanted them to go. So we're going to start off by zooming in. And then I'm going to lightly with the eraser just start seeing if I can some of it's okay, and I don't think I'm gonna go too far with trying to pull some of this up. I'm going to pull out, I have this rose pink Holbein, which is 429, and I also have this lilac Holbein 422 that I'm going to use and bring back. I just wanna put in a little bit of lightness. Also got this Cosmos Holbein, which is 437. And then I'm going to bring the violet out. I got to start being careful because if I get too aggressive at this point, we're going to start losing the integrity of the page and the gouache I have laid down. We don't necessarily want that. Also pulling a white out. Add a little bit of that lilac in her cheek. Okay. If I jump to the body of Mrs. Potts and Chip, for that matter, I have all of these warm grays pulled out. So I have warm gray 1, warm gray 2, warm gray 3, and warm gray 4. These are all in my polychromos. You can for sure use the Holbeins or any set of warm grays. But this is 270, 271, 272, and 273. I am going to start with the four. Make sure I've got the darker areas started so that we don't accidentally lose those. Probably gonna look a little silly for a hot second. I think I'll just start with Mrs. Potts, and then I'll move to Chip after I've got her in a place that I'm comfortable with. Might have to add a little bit of blue. I have this smoke gray Holbein, which is 379. Hi, welcome. Thank you. I'm glad you like it. So I'm just trying to give some of these highlights a little bit of color. I think it's reflections off of the snow and off of the stonework, which is why we've got this blue. I'm also going to pull the white out and kind of make sure we keep some of those areas highlighted. I'm gonna keep, just put down a layer of white. So anything that goes on in some of that same area is going to, by default, go down lighter. This is the warm gray two, and then I'm going to pull the warm gray one out. Go over the some of those same areas that I did that pure white. And then I'm going to start back in with that warm gray four. And really start darkening some of those areas. This is the warm gray three. Might have to, closer to the end, go in with maybe a Posca to get those highlights really showing. One thing that I am always a little sad about. When I color with colored pencils, is the fact that I don't quite get that sharpness. Of course, it's gonna look a little weird for a hot second because it is just the grays. Let's see if we can add. A little bit of structure with the gold. So I have four colors pulled to do their gold highlights, and that is two Holbeins and two Polychromos. And the Holbeins, I have the Mustard 165. In tan 192, and in the polychromos, I have green gold 268 and raw umber 180. So mustard and the green gold are by far the lightest versions of both of those colors. I'm gonna start with a base of mustard. These spots are so tiny, I don't know how much definition I'm actually going to be able to get. And I don't even know how much definition the camera is going to pick up. And then putting a little bit of that green gold in there. Then we have the tan. And then we have the darkest of it, and that's the raw umber. That doesn't quite go nearly as dark as I would like it to go. Might have to. Just broke the tip. Sorry, didn't mean to like make a loud noise in anybody's ear. See, part of the issue is that these guys are in such a shadowed part of the picture that I have to start out coloring them shaded, and it looks really bizarre against the white of the page. I have just grabbed the black. Just so I can get some better definition in some of these areas. That we've lost a little bit of. Probably pull out the white as well, just so I can do some quick white highlighting. Hopefully, as I start to do the stonework, it feels a little bit more cohesive. Like I said, these guys look like they have been out all night, so they're a little grungy. But it's just because, in theory, they are in the shadows right now. But since I have some of these gold tones pulled out, I'm going to deviate real quick. And I want to try something with the beast. Okay, I think I want to do the tan. He's just leaning a little too yellow for me. Let me see if I can add just a soft touch of a more orange note. It's another one of those things. It just might feel a little off because I haven't added the rest of the picture yet. Okay. Still not exactly where I want it to be, but I gotta remind myself I'm working in a really small picture with fine details with colored pencils that don't necessarily go that fine. Okay. And grab, do. What do I want to grab real quick? Actually, I want to keep that tan out. That's a green gold. Because really quickly, I want to add just a small touch of tan notes to some of the stonework. The thing about wood, it always has, not wood, stone. Getting too into what I'm doing, I'm not paying attention to what I'm saying. It's always got touches of a whole bunch of different colors in it. That's a pretty decent place to start. Okay. I've got. I'm probably going to pull some of the cool gray or warm grays that I used in the pots family, but I've also got this cool gray too from the Holbeins. I've got this dark indigo 157 from the Polychromos. I've got indigo 460 from the Holbein, and I've also got this ivory 116 from the Holbein. The idea here is that there's all those different touches that we don't and to lose. So this is the ivory, and there's some highlights that happen in this stonework that I want just a touch of that ivory. There's a little bit of creaminess to these stones. Also gonna pull out the white. There's some very hard highlights on parts of this. And I always like to set those a little bit with the white before I even get started. Oops. I don't accidentally lose them. Some of those blue gray notes, real quick. So I'm being pretty light and loose right now. Okay. I think 57's a little bit darker than 460. So I'm going to take the indigo. I'm just kind of adding a light version of the shadows right now. You can see the structure of that stonework. I did also pull the smoke blue 379 and the lilac 422 Holbeins for a little bit of this stonework as well. And then the smoke blue. We have the dark indigo. Oops. Ooh, coffee break. Take my Fitbit off real quick because it keeps clanking on the desk and I am not enjoying that. I'm gonna get that tan back. Okay, let's see. This is the warm gray one. Going to grab the warm gray 3. Okay, and then the cool gray too. I think I'm gonna have to start getting hyper detailed in certain areas. Now that we've kind of got that full coverage. Okay, so I got the smoke gray. I'm just gonna kind of come back and forth between colors. Sorry, I'm not saying which ones I'm using when I'm using that. I'm flipping so fast between these things. Kind of just following my instincts at this point. This is the mustard. Just wanted to add a little bit. me zoom out so you can get a broader feel for how this is shaping up. Is there any more I want to do that? I don't know. Yeah, I kind of like it. Wondering. Yeah. I'm gonna grab this khaki real quick. A dusty rose, cinnamon, slight flesh, ash rose. There we go. It's the thing about Kincaid. There's so many levels to his paints. That you end up using a whole bunch of colors just trying to mimic it. Kind of like it. I mean, it's far from perfect, but we're trying to recreate it with colored pencils. I think that's looking pretty good. Oopsie. Some of those highlights back in there. Where I want to leave it? I don't know why I have Bad Romance stuck in my head right now, but I do. Okay. Let's see if I can put these colored pencils in any kind of order. Oh yeah. So we've been watching the new National Treasure series on Disney Plus. And there was a scene with that song in it, and I guess it is now forever in my brain. It's there. It's not gonna leave. It's stuck. Wherever. I don't know why I feel the need to like organize these pencils. No benefit to anybody. And I have these two that need to mark down since I didn't originally have them set up for this part of the piece. Yeah. So there might be a little more tan in some of these other, in these areas than there probably should be. But ultimately, I think that's okay. At some point, it transitions into it being more reminiscent of me than of Kincaid. Okay, I'm not going to touch it anymore. I don't want to overwork it. So we've been at this for what, an hour and a half, which seems to be pretty standard for working on areas about that big. Because I mean, we started with Belle, we moved to the Beast, and now we did this bottom corner with the pots. In theory, I have some of the same colors that went into this stonework. That will go into these statues and probably the castle. So I think we'll start touching some of those pieces next time. So we'll start looking at the castle and in that stone lion. So it's this part of the picture. So starting in on the background, I think I might leave like this big swath of snow around Belle and the Beast, probably more towards the end. Because I can see getting these done and then wanting to work on the mountain and the sky and the water and then the trees and then the snow area. That might be how I decide to hit all of this, but you guys can influence that as well. What do you want to see me do next? How do you want to see me color next? But I'm going to leave it for today. I'm going to get a picture of this and I'm going to put it up on Instagram and on my community tab. So maybe you get more of a true tone compared to what's showing up on camera right now. And then we'll be back here again next weekend, same time, same place, 11 Central, my channel on Sunday. I hope to see you there. And I heart your beautiful faces. Bye.